me and my co-author, Ben Noble, we choose the myth connected with this very decision-making process, which is often understood as coming from one single person. The role and the importance of public institutions and of state institutions is underestimated. Because Russia is not a democracy, and because it's not exactly a country of the rule of law, the natural conclusion is that rules are not important, that legislation is not important, and that political institutions are just for show. So it has been the saying of Nicholas I, one of Russia's more autocratic czars. He said once that it is not I who rule Russia, it is 30,000 stolonachalniki, literally the desk officers, the bureaucrats. So these 30,000 have since grown to 3 million. Therefore, as many decisions as are taken every minute in this decision-making system cannot all be brought back to one person or to one person and his circle of closest friends. I think that especially for outside observers, it's important to attract their attention to the institutions and to the rules. The question I get asked like every second day, what does he really believe? Or does he really believe what he says? These types of psychological analysis is not political science. It's not any type of science. It's gossip, hearsay. There's nothing really so mysterious about the way Russia works. It just needs a little or a lot of practice and understanding. Bureaucratic language is hard for an outsider. It's hard for a Russian speaker. You need practice to just begin to understand what is being written and what is being said and what is the meaning of all this. Bureaucratic language is intentionally vague. So you need time to learn it. But once you learn it, quite a lot of things become clear and transparent to you. And this cloud of mystery starts to dispel.
My myth is connected with the belief that the life after Putin will be better than the life with Putin in terms of relationship between Russia and the West. The West is too much focused on Putin and Putin as a person, and not that much it's paying attention to Russia's national interests and how they express by different elite groups, and not only elites, but Russians in general. And that's the reason of certain miscalculations. Partly it's connected with the fact that the foreign policy is based on resentment feelings shared by majority of Russians. That's why if you are looking at sociological polls asking whether respondents do support politics of the Kremlin, in case of foreign policy, support is biggest of all. So big share of Russians do wholeheartedly support foreign policy. And not only this is due to a propagandist machine, but it's due to the fact that this foreign policy somehow responds to their resentment feelings, feelings of being citizens of the great country of superpower, which lost its status and which was somehow in their view humiliated by the West. And the problem I see is connected with growth of populism. Not only there is populism in Russia, and as I've tried to explain, Putin is reflecting expectations of ordinary Russians, but there is the huge wave of populism at the West, which does not make it that easy to formulate, to announce any strategic position, which should be much more complicated and perhaps not that positively taken by ordinary citizens in any country. And that's why I would say that in my view, the biggest contribution perhaps with regard to more balanced position of the West vis-a-vis Russia will be not that much connected with Russia herself, will be connected with strengthening of the West, of the political systems there and of the management there.